Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today I have a 1U server, the TYAN Transport CX B8056G68AE12HR-2T. This thing. Try and say that five times fast. There are two versions of this system based off of the GC68AB8056 chassis. As usual, they are very similar, the only difference being this one with the -2T on the end has dual 10 gigabit Ethernet ports on the back of the system. The other doesn't. Both support AMD EPYC Genoa CPUs. Those would be the fourth generation 9004 series CPUs. Oh, and hit that subscribe button if you like our hardware reviews, as there will be more to come. Let's take a look. At 1U, this system supports all NVMe U.2 drives up front with support for DDR5 memory and PCIe 5.0. Now, those processors are what makes this interesting. Mind you, the actual manufacturer page for this system mentioned Genoa X and Bergamo processors. And I did get a little excited about that, given there haven't been that many systems supporting Bergamo processors yet. Apparently, this system has a configurable thermal design power rating of up to 300 watts, but there is conditional support for those with up to 400 watts, given the list of supported processors anyways. It's unfortunate. I was definitely going on another virtual vacation through Italy to locate Bergamo. I've heard of Naples, Rome, Milan, Genoa, but Bergamo? I can assure you it is on the map, like just northeast of Milan. Although to be honest, looks kind of like a sleepy backwater village with quaint cobblestone streets compared to the others. Really doesn't matter though. No Bergamo support, or perhaps there is, but it's not quite clear. As a Transport CX system, it supports an AMD EPYC processor, and the CX part indicates it's designed for cloud applications. If it was an Intel-based system, it would be a Thunder CX. The front of the chassis features 12 drive bays for U.2 NVMe drive types, with four of those bays supporting SATA at 6 gigabits per second, or SAS at 12 gigabits per second. The left server ear has a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 port, and the right server ear, the power on button and ID button, both with integrated LED. On the back of the chassis, the 1 plus 1 redundant 850-watt 80-plus platinum PSUs are aligned to the left-hand side. Next to those, an RJ45 LAN port dedicated for the integrated platform management interface with USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports below. Then a VGA port and a serial port and the two 10 gigabit Ethernet RJ45 ports, which are absent on the other version of this system. On the far end, an OCP card slot with two PCIe slots above and the ID button and LED light to the left. Are you interested in the TYAN Transport CX Beat this thing? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that you configure or is listed on our site at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. This is a limited time offer, but you could probably still haggle a little later on. ITCreations.com. Management of the system is through the Integrated Baseboard Management Controller, or BMC, which is IPMI 2.0 compatible. The RJ45 port on the back of the system connects to the AST2600 chip for remote management of the system and IKVM support. TYAN TSM Plus 2.0 offers out-of-band and in-band management of the server and web-based group server management with a graphics-rich user interface. Administrators can remotely access the system to monitor and manage the system, plus track hardware assets, access event logs, and get alert notifications in the event of a problem. Popping the cover off of this chassis, you can see with the PSUs on the left-hand side, the six fans are all on the right, pumping fresh air over the single CPU socket and 24 memory module slots. The single AMD EPYC processor has a 12 memory channel architecture. With 24 memory module slots, the system can be loaded with two DIMMs per channel for up to 3 terabytes of memory using registered or 3DS registered DDR5 memory modules. Honestly, I was expecting a little bit more given AMD says Genoa CPUs are capable of supporting up to 6 terabytes of memory. As I stated in previous videos, DDR5 memory modules offer a 1.6 times increase in performance compared to the previous generation DDR4 memory modules. Depending on the CPU and installed memory modules, memory will run at speeds of up to 4,800 megatransfers per second, 4,400 megatransfers per second, or 4,000 megatransfers per second. The server has a configurable thermal design power, or TDP, range of up to 300 watts. Conditional support is available for CPUs with a TDP greater than 300 watts, which includes those with 3DV cache, like the 9684X with up to 1.15 gigabytes of L3 cache and 96 cores. That one has a TDP of 400 watts and is designed for a narrow range of applications like fluid dynamics, databases, and electronic design automation, to name a few. Those that would actually benefit from having that large data cache at the processor. AMD did add an X suffix on their Genoa X lineup, so easy to differentiate. Most likely and completely unexplained, you will need some kind of optional performance heatsink or perhaps liquid cooling to install one of those high TDP CPUs. Our system today has a single 32-core AMD EPYC 9354P processor with a TDP of 280 watts, 3.25 megahertz base frequency, and 256 gigabytes of L3 cache, standard Genoa. The P suffix on the end of that SKU means this processor is designed for a single socket implementation. With all 24 memory module slots outfitted with 64 gigabyte memory modules, we have 1.5 terabytes installed. The backplane supports 12 NVMe U.2 drive types with 4 slots that can support SATA at 6 gigabytes per second or SAS at 12 gigabytes per second. On this build, we are flush with NVMe storage. There are 2 U.2 NVMe drives with 6.4 terabytes of storage that offer a slightly faster read speed compared to the 10 NVMe drives with 7.68 terabytes of storage. 2 1-terabyte M.2 drives can be installed on the motherboard to boot the system. There is a 2-level PCIe slot on the system board, so those M.2s stack right on top of each other with a clip on the end to hold them in place. That clip also serves as keeping a little separation for airflow and heat dissipation. The OCP card slot is outfitted with an NVIDIA ConnectX 5 adapter card offering dual-port SFP28 ports. The butterfly riser included on this system supports 2 PCIe 5.0 slots, both with a x16 physical slot length and x16 link width. The integrated NVMe controller on the EPYC CPUs does not provide RAID functionality. Other options for NIC controllers include PCIe-based 200 gigabit Ethernet, QSFP56, and 100 gigabit Ethernet, QSFP28, with 1 and 2 ports respectively. Same with that OCP card slot, offering 100 and 200 gigabit Ethernet. For RAID functionality on this system, Supermicro offers the Grade Supreme RAID SR1010 or the SR1000. The SR1010 is designed off of an NVIDIA T1000 card and offers what Grade says is still a software RAID solution, not hardware. It plugs into one of those 2 available PCI slots and offers tri-mode support for NVMe, SAS, and SATA with RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, 6, or 10 and can support up to 32 physical drives. Billed as the world's fastest NVMe or NVMe over fabric RAID cards for PCIe 4.0, the SR1010 with PCIe 4.0 interface is twice as fast as the Supreme RAID SR1000, which uses a PCIe 3.0 interface. Sequential read is listed at 110 gigabytes per second and sequential write at 22 gigabytes per second. Grade said it offers 5 to 8 times the performance compared to a standard HD RAID controller, effectively bypassing the CPU so it can perform other tasks. Plus, it has an AI engine and computational resources available on the GPUS card and will directly process the I/O. It's also designed for NVMe over fabric so you can utilize the full potential of those NVMe drives with 16 million IOPS and 110 gigabytes of throughput. As a cloud computing platform, the TYAN Transport CX B8056G68AE12HR-2T delivers exceptional power efficiency and performance thanks to those Genoa and potentially Genoa X CPUs. With only that single processor, it can deliver up to 128 cores with contingent cooling, or up to 84 cores if we're going with the configurable TDP limit. You can add the asterisk later. If you like this video, consider subscribing and giving it a thumbs up. Not surprising, it won't cost you anything. And you get more of this. Maybe I didn't sell that very well. That said, if you are looking for this system or perhaps a GPU server, networking server, or anything to support your current infrastructure, try IT Creations. Just click that link right there or one of the links in the description below. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.